Hi everyone, welcome back to Rotation of Motion. This time we're going to be talking about torque, which is the angular form of force. Alright, so let's look at this first problem. A 1.1 kilogram wrench is trying to twist a nut. 1.1 kilogram wrench. The length of the wrench lies directly to the east of the nut, so that means just kind of like perpendicular to it. A force of 150 newton acts on the wrench at position 15 centimeters from the center of the nut. So 15 centimeters, so 0.15 meters. In a direction 30 degrees north of east, what is the magnitude of the torque? It should actually say north of west, but it'll give you the same answer either way. So remember, for the equation for torque, torque is equal to force times radius times sine of theta. And this should make sense because the more force you use anywhere along here, the more this is going to twist. Also, the further out you are, the more force you use, it's going to be easier to twist. And the angle. So the angle just shows that the more perpendicular it is, the more use the force is going to get. So if it's not as angled, it's going to have a harder time twisting. So let's just plug in what we have. So force, which is equal to 150, radius, which is equal to 0.15, and sine. This is the tricky part. So you want to look at the axis of rotation. So you want to draw kind of a line from the axis of rotation. And we see this angle of where the force is and where the angle of rotation is. This angle here is what we're looking for, and we know that's 30 degrees. So this is going to be sine of 30. Let me erase that real quick. Sine of 30. And then if we put this into our calculators, 150 times 0.15 times sine of 30, we get 11.25 newton per meter. Okay. What this also shows is if we were to pull this straight up, what we'd have is we'd have an angle of 90 degrees, which would give us twice the amount of torque. And that should make sense because the more you're going perpendicular to the force, the more efficient it's going to be. All right, let's look at the next example. To open a revolving door, a force is applied to a distance at a distance r from the axis of rotation. If the minimum torque required to open the door is 3.1 newton per meter, what force must be applied if the lever is 0.94 meters away, 0.35 meters away? Okay, so let's look at part A. So part A, this part is 0.94 meters away, and we want to know what force does it need. Again, torque is equal to force times radius times sine of theta. We know in order to revolve this door, you need a torque of 3.1. We don't know what force is. That's what we're looking for. And we're going to be 0.94 meters away. This is going to be an angle of 90 degrees. And we know sine of 90 is just 1, so we're just going to leave that there. So now let's find what the force is equal to. 3.1 divided by 0.94, and we get 3.3 newtons. Okay. So when we're further away, closer, 0.35, we should know that this is going to be harder. We're going to need more force the closer you are to the axis. Okay, so let's figure that out. Part B, torque is equal to force times radius times sine of theta. Again, we need 3.1 newton per meter to rotate the door. We don't know what force we're going to use. We're going to be closer this time at a distance of 0.35. But again, we're going perpendicularly. So sine of 90 is just 1. 3.1 divided by 0.35. And we're going to see we're going to need 8.86 newtons of force in order to open it if we're closer. Okay. All right. Two people are trying to hold the door shut from a dinosaur.
Dinosaur?
That is trying to get in. The dinosaur pushes on the door with a force of 88 newtons at 40 degrees, 0.6 meters from the hinge. So this is getting pushed 88 newtons, 40 degrees. Okay? And 0.6 meters from the hinge. The other person pushes with the force of 17 newtons to the door 1.2 meters away. Okay. One of the people pushed with the force 28 newtons. So this person is pushing 28 newtons, 0.8 meters from the hinge of the door. 0.8 meters from the hinge of the door. Okay, this is kind of like a bird's eye view. The last person is going to be 1.2 meters away and going vertically, perpendicular, so 17 newtons. So now we want to find what the net torque is. Okay, so net torque, that's what we want to find. So we want to find the torque of each of these. I'm going to call this 1, 2, 3. So torque 1 is going to equal force, 88, times radius, 0.6, times sine of 40. We can see it's 40 degrees from where the hinge is. The hinge is going to be right here. Okay, so 40 degrees. Okay, so let's look at the second torque. We see that this force is going to be 28 newtons. It's going to be 0.8 meters away. It's going to be sine of 70. It's going to be 70 degrees from the hinge. Okay, and if we put that into our calculators, we get 28 times 0.8 times 70, sine of 70, and we get 21.05 newton per meter. Now let's look at this. If we were to only look at this force here, and this was the only person yet, that means he would twist the door going this way. That means counterclockwise, this door would twist if we only look at this force. So that's a positive torque. The last torque, torque 3, this has a force of 17 times 1.2 meters away times sine, and it's perpendicular, so that's 90 degrees. Let me just do 17 times 1.2, and we get 20.4 newton per meter. Again, if we were to look at this, only this force, and we were to see how it would rotate this way, which is counterclockwise, which means this would be positive. Now let's put this into our calculator. The net torque is just adding all of these up. So negative 33.94 plus 21.05 plus 20.4, and we get 7.51 newton per meter. Which way will it accelerate? So it will accelerate toward the dinosaur. Okay, so toward the dinosaur or counterclockwise. Clockwise. All right, let's look at the next problem. Number 4. Okay, so two forces act on a wheel. The wheel is free to rotate without friction. It has a radius of 0.42 meters. Okay, so this is 0.42 meters. And is initiated at rest. Given that F1 is equal to 12 newtons, okay, so this is equal to 12 newtons. F2 is equal to 9.5 newtons. Find the net torque caused by all the forces. So net torque, again, okay, so we're going to call this number 1 and this number 2. So let's find all the torques. So first here, torque 1 is equal to the force. The force for the first one is 12 times the radius, 0.42 times sine of theta. So this one's a little tricky, but we can see it right here is the axis rotation. And if we were to make a straight line right here, that means that this is going to be 50 degrees from the axis rotation. If you went this way, you could do that. This would be 130 degrees, and that'll give you the same answer. But I'm just going to put 50 degrees. Okay, so that'll give you the same answer. 50 degrees. And then now let's look at this. 12 times 0.42. Times sine of 50, and we get 3.86 newton per meter. Okay, let's look at this a little further. Let's see, so if I were to just look at this force and this force pushing on it, we can see that this wheel would rotate like this. It would rotate counterclockwise. So I'm going to call this positive. Okay, now let's look at torque 2. Torque 2, the force is equal to 9.5 times the radius, 0.42, times sine. And now we can see, okay, this is the axis rotation. We draw a straight line, and the angle would be 90 degrees. So if the angle is 90 degrees, that means this would just be 1. And then we have 9.5 times 0.42, and we get 3.99 newton per meter. And we see if this was to rotate on its own, if this was the only force acting on it, rotate it, it would rotate this way, which is clockwise, which is negative. So if we were to now put this into our calculator, we would get the net torque as negative 0.13 newton per meter. In which direction would the wheel be spinning? Clockwise. And that negative shows that it will be going clockwise. Okay. All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you with the next one.